मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग.
मैम टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर.
यस बेटा.
मैम टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर.
व्हिच चैप्टर?
मैम आवर रिसोर्सेस.
नो नो वी हैव नॉट कंप्लीटेड.
नो मैम वी हैव जस्ट डन.
मैम वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आवर रिसोर्सेस. मैम इन अर्लियर पीरियड मैम यू हैव गिवन अस द मैप एंड फ्लो चार्ट.
यस मैम.
यस.
Okay, okay. With your class, we have not completed the chapter, right?
No, yes, ma'am. We have started.
Fine.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta. Good morning. Okay. What is a resource? Can anybody tell me? In general. Can you tell me what is
ma'am any element of the ma'am any element of the environment which can be used
as a which can be given usefulness? Okay. Yes Tanishka.
Ma'am can I? Yes, ma'am anything in the ma'am the world which can be used ma'am for some work or ma'am for something.
Morning, ma'am.
Okay.
Morning.
Okay. If I tell you that if I say stone,
ma'am, can I?
Stone has a use. Yes, Tanishka.
Ma'am,
can we say that stone has a usage?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please tell.
It is an abiotic resource then where it is useful.
Ma'am, stone is a natural resource.
Okay. And can you tell me, is it useful for us or not?
Yes, ma'am, it is very useful for us to build our house and ma'am build our road.
Okay. If I say wood.
Ma'am, wood is also very useful for make ma'am furniture.
Okay, very good.
And ma'am, it's a natural resource.
Okay, it's a natural resource. If I say water.
Ma'am, it is used for.
It's a natural resource, and ma'am, it is used for drinking and cooking and many more things.
Very good. If I say waterfall.
Ma'am, it's also a natural resource, and it is uses in the mountain range for fulfill their needs of drinking water and their needs.
Okay. Take. Okay. Any other use of waterfall can you tell?
Yes, ma'am.
For drinking. Ma'am, irrigation in terrace farming.
Yes. Okay, very good. What else? Can we produce electricity from the waterfalls?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, we can.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Very good. So, again, water is a very useful resource, right? It can be utilized for several purposes, including producing electricity, right? Right, class?
coming.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, when we say resource, everything that is available on the earth and fulfills some or the other need of human beings is called a resource. Right?
Yes,
right,
ma'am.
Class? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You see? We as human beings, we have utilized all the natural products that are available on the surface of the earth for our needs, as per our needs and as per the demands that were rising, right? We as human beings, we are very intelligent intellectuals. We know how to make use of several products or several substances or elements that are available on the surface of the earth, right? We as human beings, we work as a workforce. There are several industries where human or the manpower is used, right? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
When we say land, when we say, you know, when we say land, there are several uses of land, we all know, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Uses of land. So, keeping this in mind, when we say land, when we say resources, we are basically talking about all those substances that are available on the earth and has the capacity to fulfill the needs of the humans. We as human beings, because we are intelligent, right? We are different from animals, no? We have been given this brain, right? We have the ability to utilize all the substances that are on the surface of the earth to its maximum utilization, right? Coal was just a piece. We as human beings, we made its use possible, right? Water was a very natural resource. It was easily available on naturally, but we as human beings, we have, you know, found various uses of water, right? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, if you all have the flowcharts with you, can you please open it with you all and I'll be explaining you as per the flowchart, right?
Ma'am, this color of notebook is fine.
Yes,
this color.
Very good. Blue only. Very good, Tanishka. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, when we say the use of resource, depends upon.
Ma'am, we have to write this in notebook.
No, you don't have to write. I'm just explaining it to you. Okay? See, the uses of resources, they depend on various factors. Now, one is the need of the people. Whatever is the need of the people of a region, then second is their knowledge, and third is the level of technology they possess. Level of technology they possess. Fine class. Now see,
yes.
if in a particular area the agricultural fields are there, but there is no sufficient supply of water, so what that area needs a water resource which can be used for the irrigation of the fields. So in that case, either a canal will be made over there, or a water body that is passing through by that region will be diverted towards the region so that people can utilize the water for the irrigation of the fields, right? If in an area, lot of residential places are required, so that land area, all the resources that are available will be used for constructing the houses for the people, right? If in an area, there are several mineral resources available. So the industries that will come up will be of utilizing all those resources that are available, right? Right? See, need of the people, what is the need of the time? What knowledge do they have as per that? And what is the level of technology that they possess? Do they have the technology to harness the waterfalls into converting electricity, right? So all these factors, these three things are very important to consider to make a substance a resource, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, when we talk of the types of resources, see, when we talk about the types of resources, we say
there are types of resources.
And there are three types of resources.
Yes.
And natural, human, and human-made resource.
And human-made. Right? When we say types of resources, we are basically talking about the natural, human, and the human-made resources. The other day when we were doing this flow chart, I told you that when we talk of the natural resources, they can be categorized on the basis of the, on various bases, right? They are classified on various bases. When we say natural resources, we say on the basis of origin. They are on the basis of origin, they are biotic. And abiotic. Right? Now, what is meant by bio? Just a second, beta.
When can I tell the biotic?
Wait. Okay. When we say biotic, we are basically... Yes, Tanishka, you tell, beta.
Ma'am, biotic means for ma'am living beings.
Huh. All those resources that are obtained from the living beings, or in other words, we can say all the plants and animals that we have on the earth, they make the biotic resources, right? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Then when we talk of the abiotic resources, we are basically talking about all those resources which are available on in the physical environment. And when we say physical environment,
all living.
Talking about land, water, air,
stones.
Yes, beta. Okay. Now, when we say abiotic, we are basically.
Ma'am, non-living thing.
Ma'am, non-living thing.
Hanji, yes, Tanishka was saying something.
Yes, ma'am, abiotic is a ma'am non-living thing.
Yes. Everything that does not has life in it comes under the abiotic component, right? Or we can say all the non-living components of the physical environment comprise the abiotic components, right? Right? Biotic and abiotic is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now coming to the next. On the basis of
ma'am, renewability.
Yes. Renewability means to renew oneself, right? So all those resources that can be renewed in a short span of time, they fall in this category of renewability, right? So when we say renewability, we again divide it into renewable
and non-renewable.
Fine. Now, what is renewable? Something, all those resources which are there on the earth but has the capacity to renew itself in a short span of time. Whereas all those resources that are there on the surface of the earth, but once they are exhausted, they take lot of time to renew itself. This is clear to everyone? Like,
ma'am,
please explain it again.
Explaining. When we use water, right? So water will finish or it will come again?
Ma'am, it will come again.
Exactly. Through rains, through rivers, through oceans, through the melting ice caps which are there, right? But when we are using coal, can it be renewed in a short span of time? Can it be renewed in short span of time? No, it cannot. Because it takes times, years of years and years to make coal, right? Right? Okay. So this is what you have. But then there are certain minerals, beta, which can be renewed, which can be recycled with a proper technology if we have, like iron and gold, sorry, gold and silver. Okay. Now, coming to the next, on the basis of stage of development.
Then potential and
actual. Very good. Potential and actual.
Actual.
Ma'am, I made the flowchart notebook of it.
Very good. Now, when we say,
and I have also made
development here means all those resources that have been recognized and that have been used, you know, for various purposes, they are the actual resources, right? We know there are certain resources. We know the usages also of those resources. So we say that they are the actual resources. Fine. And when we say that a resource is there, it has the ability to serve us, but because of lack of knowledge, how to use it, lack of technology. We don't have sufficient technology to put that resource in use. Then we say it is a potential resource. जैसे टीचर्स बोलते हैं ना कि भाई पेरेंट्स पीटीएम में बोलते हैं ना भाई आपके बच्चे में बहुत कैपेसिटी है, आपके बच्चे का बहुत पोटेंशियल है, पर पूरा यूज ही नहीं करता है. वो फर्स्ट आ सकता है पर वो फर्स्ट आता ही नहीं है क्योंकि वो पढ़ना नहीं चाहता है अच्छे से, वो कंसंट्रेट नहीं करता है. बोलते हैं ना टीचर्स, ऐसे बोलते हैं ना. सो मीन्स दैट एज वी एज ह्यूमन बींग्स, यू एज स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव द पोटेंशियल टू स्कोर बेटर, बट बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन or maybe because you have not understood the concepts, you are not able to give your maximum, right class?
Yes ma'am.
This is the basic difference between potential and actual resource. Ab potential resource ki agar hum baat karte hain beta, to jo hawa hoti hai, wind ke andar bahut potential hota hai. Wind se bhi aap energy jo hai wo जेनरेट कर सकते हैं ना.
मैं विंडमिल, यस मैम, विंडमिल फॉर एग्जांपल.
और फिर सोलर, जो सनलाइट होती है उसमें भी बहुत पोटेंशियल होता है ना टू बिकम एनर्जी, टू गिव एनर्जी टू अस. तो ये आप ही समझ.
मैम एग्जांपल सोलर पैनल,
बिकॉज़ यस, बिकॉज़ इन आवर कंट्री वी डोंट हैव सफिशिएंट यू नो टेक्नोलॉजी टू हार्नेस द यूटिलिटी ऑफ विंड एंड सनलाइट. That is why they, for us, they are the potential resources. And coal, petroleum, because we know the quantity and the amount in which they are available, and we have utilized them also as resource. So they are the actual resources, right? Now these actual resources that we have, we do not use them at once. हम एक ही बार में तो उसको यूज नहीं करते हैं ना. मम्मा अगर चॉकलेट लाके देती है तो, मम्मा अगर चॉकलेट लाके देती है तो हम क्या करते हैं, 50% आज खाते हैं, 50% कल खाते हैं, ताकि हम दो दिन चॉकलेट को एंजॉय कर सके. करते हैं आप लोग ऐसा? वही हम बता रहे हैं. ठीक ऐसे ही, ठीक ऐसे ही जो हमारे एक्चुअल रिसोर्सेज हैं, उनको हमने कुछ तो हमने अभी यूज कर रहे हैं, कुछ को हमने एज अ रिजर्व रख दिया है ताकि फ्यूचर में उसको हम यूज कर सके. ठीक है, ठीक है, ताकि जो जो चीज हम आज उसकी जो चीज हम आज यूटिलाइज कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में भी हम उसको यूटिलाइज कर सके. राइट क्लास? वेरी गुड. नाउ कमिंग टू दी लास्ट बेसिस.
On the basis of distribution.
Yes, on the basis of. Distribution. We say ubiquitous and
localized.
Right?
Ma'am, localized. Ubiquitous and localized.
लोकल का मतलब जो, अच्छा यूबिकिटस का मतलब क्या होता है जानते हैं? यूबिकिटस का मतलब होता है समथिंग दैट इज अवेलेबल एवरीवेयर, सब जगह जो मिलती है. ठीक है, ठीक है. और लोकल मतलब, लोकल मतलब जो किसी पर्टिकुलर जगह पे मिलती है. जैसे अगर हम बात करें सनलाइट की, सॉरी अगर हम बात करते हैं कोल की, तो ये एक लोकल रिसोर्स है जो कि छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू की तरफ बहुत ज्यादा मिलता है. ठीक है, हमने प्लेट्यूज पढ़े हैं ना, डेक्कन प्लेट्यू एंड छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू.
यस मैम.
तो कह रहे हैं कि जो आपके जो लोकल रिसोर्सेज है, अगर हम उसकी बात करते हैं, तो कोल एंड आयरन जो है ये आपका छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू रीजन में बहुत ज्यादा पाया जाता है. तो ये हो गया लोकल रिसोर्स. ठीक है, और यूबिकिटस मतलब हो गया एयर, वाटर, सनलाइट, इट इज अवेलेबल एवरीवेयर. कहीं भी आप जाओगे आपको ये सब चीजें मिलेंगी, या इसकी कोई कमी नहीं होती है. देयर इज नो डेफिशिएंसी, देयर इज नो स्केयरसिटी ऑफ ऑफ ऑल दीज रिसोर्सेज. ठीक है, यूबिक्यूटस एंड लोकल इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस मैम.
प्लीज एक्सप्लेन मैम यूबिक्यूटस.
बेटा यूबिक्यूटस मतलब हुआ वो रिसोर्स जो सब जगह अवेलेबल होता है, जैसे ये पानी, हवा, मट्टी.
एंड लोकलाइज्ड.
और लोकल रिसोर्स वो जो कि किसी पर्टिकुलर एरिया में ही पाया जाता है. जैसे
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
यस नैतिक
मैम. व्हाट सो मैम, यूबिक्विटस इज मोर बेनिफिशियल और लोकलाइज्ड मैम बेनिफिशियल?
मैम यूबिक्विटस इज बेनिफिशियल.
बेटा जो यूबिक्विटस रिसोर्स है उसका अपना यूटिलिटी है, और जो लोकलाइज होते हैं उसकी अपनी यूटिलिटी है. जो लोकलाइज रिसोर्सेज होते हैं वो किसी भी लोकल एरिया को डेवलप करने में हेल्प करते हैं. अगर वहां पे वो ज्यादा मात्रा में है तो वहां पे उसी रिसोर्स पे बेस्ड सारी चीजें होंगी, है ना. जैसे आयरन एंड स्टील प्लांट्स जो हैं, जो आयरन एंड स्टील प्लांट्स कहाँ पे सबसे ज्यादा है, किधर है वो सबसे ज्यादा बताओ? आयरन एंड स्टील प्लांट्स कहाँ पाए जाते हैं सबसे ज्यादा, जो है आपका छोटा नागपुर रीजन में, वेस्ट बंगाल में, आपका में, है ना,
छोटा
जगहों पे कोल और आयरन जो है इजिली अवेलेबल है. और आयरन एंड स्टील के बनाने के लिए हमें आयरन और कोल की अवेलेबिलिटी रिक्वायर्ड होती है. ठीक है, तो दोनों का अपना अपना यूजेज है बच्चे. यूबिक्यूटस जो है वो ज्यादा इजीली अवेलेबल होता है, फ्रीक्वेंटली अवेलेबल होता है. लोकलाइज्ड रिसोर्स किसी एक पर्टिकुलर लोकल या एरिया में ही पाया जाता है. ठीक है,
ओके मैम.
मैम कैन यू गिव द एग्जांपल ऑफ लोकलाइज्ड रिसोर्सेज?
कोल, आयरन. ठीक है,
ओके मैम.
हाँ चलो, नाउ विद दिस वी कम टू एन एंड to the natural resources on various bases. I hope this is all clear and understood to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now coming to the humans.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, humans are divided into two quantity and quality.
Quality and quantity.
Humans are divided into quality and
quantity.
कह रहा है ह्यूमन की जो क्वालिटी होती है वो कैसे पता चलती है, उसके इंटेलिजेंस से. ठीक है, ठीक है
मैम.
ओके
मैम. दीज मैम दीज रिसोर्सेज आर ह्यूमन मेड रिसोर्सेज और मैम व्हाट आर दे ह्यूमन
रिसोर्सेज. ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज. ठीक है, ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज. कह रहा है कौन होता है जब हम पता लगाते हैं कि भाई किसी एरिया में कितने ज्यादा लोग रहते हैं. अमाउंट डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. ठीक है, जैसे सेवेंथ ए बी सी सॉरी एट्थ ए बी सी दीज आर ऑल वन क्लास ओनली. नो एट सी क्लास तो है ये, पर इसमें सेक्शन सेग्रीगेशन करके रखा हुआ है हमने. सेक्शन सेग्रीगेशन करा हुआ है ना. अभी सेक्शन सेग्रीगेशन जो है इट इज बिकॉज ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास एट कैन नॉट बी अकोमोडेटेड इन वन रूम. राइट राइट.
Yes, ma'am.
Accommodate them in a classroom comfortably. This segregation is done, right? ये तो
ma'am.
अब हम आते हैं quality पे. Quality जो होती है वो होती है physical and mental well-being. Physical and mental abilities. है ना, कोई कितना strong है. खली के बारे में आपने सुना है, खली?
ग्रेट खली.
हाँ, व्हाई डू वी नो खली? बिकॉज ही इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग.
खली मैम.
ग्रेट खली इज फिजिकली वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. नो, ही इज अ रेसलर.
यस मैम, ही इज अ
रेसलर.
एंड व्हाई डू वी नो बिल गेट्स?
मैम बिकॉज
ऑफ ही इन्वेंटेड
माइक्रोसॉफ्ट. एंड मैम आल्सो आई एम गेंजीस खान.
बिकॉज ऑफ हिज
ब्रेन
मेंटल एबिलिटी. राइट right.
Yes, ma'am.
So human, yes, when we talk of quality we go by the physical as well as the mental abilities of a person. theek hai, itna clear hua?
Yes ma'am.
theek hai.
Yes ma'am.
Human beings hote hain jo human being, jo humans hote hain as a resource wo apni physical aur mental ability ke according kaam karte hain aur kisi bhi area mein jo uski quantity hoti hai wo ye decide karti hai ki wahan pe kis tarike ka kaam hoga. aap dekho जितने भी इंटेलिजेंट लोग हैं मेंटली मैक्सिमम दे ऑल आर इनटू गूगल.
मेंटल क्वालिटी
अपने अपने ब्रेन का वो मैक्सिमम यूज करके न्यू थिंग्स दे आर ब्रिंगिंग अप. नोबडी हैड एवर थॉट कि जो है गूगल जैसी कोई चीज आएगी जो कि एक ही बार में सब कुछ हमें बता देगी. जीपीएस सिस्टम इतना स्ट्रांग हो जाएगा कि बिना किसी फिजिकल हेल्प के बिना किसी इंसान की हेल्प के हम न्यू प्लेसेस पे जा सकते हैं, उनको एक्सप्लोर कर सकते हैं. ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ गूगल वी आर डूइंग इट. तो ये किसी की तो मेंटल एबिलिटी है ना जिसने उसको बनाया है कि नहीं?
यस यस
मैम. आई होप नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू.
यस मैम.
क्वालिटी और क्वांटिटी. अब जिन जगहों पे बहुत सारा जब कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट होती है जहाँ पे आपने देखा है कंस्ट्रक्शन जहाँ होते हैं वहां पे क्या चाहिए होता है? क्वांटिटी चाहिए होती है ना. Human resource.
Yes, ma'am. Quantity of material.
Yes, the quantity is required. The quantity is required so that the construction can take place easily. ठीक है? तो ये हो गया human as a resource. उसकी quality और उसकी quantity दोनों matter करते हैं. I hope I am clear and understood to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Now coming to the human made resources.
Ma'am, they are divided into one source, that is resources of structures and institutions.
What?
Ma'am, human-made resources are divided into one only. These are resources of structures and institutions.
Exactly.
Ma'am, human-made resources like only one, ma'am, structures of institutions.
Huh? You all know about this, no? Ma'am.
Ma'am, your voice is coming very lightly.
Low, it's.
Okay. What I am saying is, when we say human made resources,
ma'am, I'm not able to visible the blackboard.
Okay. Now you are able to see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Beta, when ma'am. We say human made resources, we are basically talking about everything that has been created by man. Right? So you give me examples of something that has been created by humans. Batao bhai Tanishka.
Yes. Ma'am. Ma'am, like ma'am, electronic materials and ma'am, electric materials.
Okay.
Ma'am, for example,
the invention of bulb.
Okay, Anav, what are you saying?
Ma'am, the invention of bulb.
Okay.
Ma'am, that
invention of bulb. Very
ma'am,
good. The classroom.
Ma'am, it's my ma'am, point.
It's exactly. It is absolutely fine. You said electronics. He specified bulb. Okay, it is fine, bacha. Good. At least you could help somebody to give an answer. No, right? Okay. Don't feel bad. See, when we say human-made resources, we are basically talking about all the buildings, bridges, roads, all the constructed material part that we have. Whether it is the high sky touching flats or buildings, right?
Skyscrapers,
exactly. Then, or
ma'am, wallpapers.
Monuments, everything that has been made by human comes under the human made resource, right? Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Human made resources also clear to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
जितने भी resources, bridges बोलो, buildings बोलो, roads बोलो, ये सब चीजें क्या होती हैं? The
ma'am
rate at which
the ma'am rate, the seven wonders.
हाँ, seven wonders, Taj Mahal, right? The
Red Fort.
Okay, Red Fort. चलो, when the rate at which the resources are produced. It is called the productivity. What is it called? The
productivity.
Yes.
Productivity.
Right. Fine. Right? Okay. So, the productivity depends on various factors. How advanced the infrastructure is. How good the country's economy is. How stable the country's government is, then what type of technology is used over there, and law and order situation, whether there is stability in law or people are into criminal activities, everything decides for the productivity of the resources. Am I clear, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, after this, coming to the conservation of resources. See, conservation of resources, when we say conservation of resources, we mean that how to go with the judicious use of the resources. See, we use resources, but we forget that there can be several by uses also of the resources that we are using. So what do we do at times? We simply make one use of a resource and we don't think about the other options that can be there for that particular resource, right? So conservation of resources is important because we all know once these deposits are over, it will not be possible for us to recycle them in a short period of time. When we talk of coal, when we talk of petroleum, when we call of gas, we all know that the deposits of these are quite limited. And once these are over, we won't be able to go for further depth.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? So, conservation of resources is very important. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
We should use them in a wise manner. We should not misuse the resources that we have.
Ma'am, we should not waste them.
Exactly. We should not waste them. See, I have seen many children, you know, they pass by, they go to the toilets. When they come out, they keep the taps open. They let the water go waste. Then electricity, when we are not sitting in a room, the children, many people, they don't have a habit of switching off. The unnecessary
yes, ma'am.
Moving, the lights are on. So this is all, you know, we are wasting the resources. We are wasting the energy. And that energy we are getting from the resources. And what if these resources are over? We won't be able to have energy again. And we'll be sitting in dark. Right? Right? Now, coming to the sustainable development. Conservation of resources is clear and understood to all of you, no?
Ma'am, can I tell sustainable development?
Yes, beta, tell sustainable development.
Ma'am, development that takes place without damaging the environment and that which meets the needs of the person to the resources for the generation.
Ma'am, he is just reading the book.
No problem. No issues. It's okay. Sustainable development means to sustain, to keep something going, right? So sustainable development
means to keep something preserved.
To wisely use the resources. Right, Anna?
Yes, ma'am, to keep the resources preserved for the future generation.
And when we say sustainable development, our more concern is towards preserving the resources for the future use. We cannot utilize, we cannot, you know, exploit all the resources, exhaust all the resources that we have with us now. Because if we will exploit or exhaust all of them at present, then our future will become dark. Our coming generations will not be able to use those resources. Right? Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the basic rules that are to be followed for sustainable development? All the renewable resources in
we
a
should,
sustainable manner.
Ma'am, we should conserve resources.
Okay. Then we should minimize the depletion of the natural resources. उनको हमें ऐसे ही वेस्ट नहीं जाने देना है, ठीक है? उनको हमें कंजर्व करके रखना है. फिर जो अलग अलग स्पीशीज हैं लिविंग बीइंग्स की ऑन दी अर्थ, उनको भी हमें कंजर्व करके रखना है, क्योंकि अगर वो खत्म हो जाएंगी तो हमारे आने वाली जनरेशन उनको देख ही नहीं पाएंगी. नहीं देख पाएंगी ना? डायनासोर को हम देख ही नहीं पाते, हम तो मूवीज में इमेजिन करते हैं. एनाकोंडाज वेट सॉरी डायनासोर हुआ, हम डायनासोर को मूवीज में ही देख के इमेजिन करते हैं कि इतना ह्यूज क्रिएचर रहा होगा, है ना? We have also read
yes, ma'am.
Dodos भी जो है extinct हो रहे हैं, vultures भी extinct हो रही हैं, ठीक है? फिर जो natural environment है, उसको हमें harm नहीं करना है, whatever may come, right? So this was all about the chapter resources. You all need to read the chapter on your own. I have explained each and every topic over here. Let me know in the next class where are your doubts. Fine, and if there are no doubts, then we will continue with the exercises and the question answer.
Exercises.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Fine. Thank you.
Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Listening to your teacher, paying attention, and do revise. Okay, beta.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Good afternoon. Good morning to all of you.